We're very excited today to welcome you to 320 Chestnut Street. And as you will hear from our speakers, it is a truly historic opportunity to preserve a beautiful building. My name is Ruth Smith. I'm the Chief Communications Officer for New Hanover County. I feel very blessed to be here and just delighted to welcome you all on a sunny, if not windy, day. I forgot to tell them not to put the wind machine on. We're going to start our program today with our Chair of the Board of Commissioners, Beth Dawson.
Good afternoon. On behalf of your New Hanover County Board of Commissioners, Vice Chairman Jonathan Barfield, Commissioner Skip Watkins, Commissioner Woody White, and Rob Zappel, we welcome you all here today as we gather to celebrate the completion of the renovation and preservation of this county administration building, also known as 320 Chestnut. This is a great day for New Hanover County and for the departments and employees that will call 320 Chestnut home. I would like to thank you all for attending today and introduce many of our special guests and partners who have worked with us tirelessly through these past couple of years. I'd like to recognize the Honorable Jay Corpening, who is always with us for important issues to the county. Our state representatives, Representative Ted Davis and Representative Rick Catlin, if he attends. Very special to have with us today are former county commissioners, Commissioner Jason Thompson and Bobby Greer. Thank you all for being with us and for all of the work you've done for the county through the years. I'd also like to recognize our public defender, Jennifer Harjo, who is with us, who will be glad to move in. I think she has moved into her office here at 320 Chestnut to be able to serve so many folks. And as always, we are pleased to have our partners with the City of Wilmington. Mayor Bill Sappho, thank you for being with us. Mayor Pro Tem Margaret Haynes, Councilman Kevin O'Grady, and Council Members Paul Lawler, Charlie Rivenbark, I believe, may be joining us. If they arrive, we'll thank them for your partnerships and all that we do to work together for the citizens and our community. Our New Hanover County Registrar of Deeds, Tammy Beasley, and her department will be relocating here. I know this will be a great office to be able to serve the citizens of New Hanover County. From the Historic Wilmington Foundation, our good friend George Edwards. Thank you for being with us, George. And from Wilmington Downtown Inc., who I know is glad to see this project finally come to fruition, Ed Wolverton, thank you for being with us. And always our Greater Wilmington Chamber of Commerce, Connie Majorette, thank you for everything you do for our community. And so we certainly, New Hanover County is certainly proud to have partnered with a great team of professionals that share in the success of this downtown revitalization and economic development effort. Our commitment to historic preservation while implementing modern efficiencies has resulted in offices for our departments that will serve our citizens for many, many years to come. New Hanover County strives to be a good steward of our citizens' assets, and the completion of 320 Chestnut is a prime example of government being a good steward of both our historic resources as well as our citizens' property assets. I'm pleased to report that this project came in within budget and relatively on time, within 30 days. Challenges were presented with the discovery of an old cemetery. However, with the help of UNC Wilmington's Department of Anthropology, the remains were handled reverently and respectfully. We also would like to thank George Edwards again and the Historic Wilmington Foundation for all they do for historic preservation and for recognizing early on the importance of the preservation of the Tidewater Building and its place in the history of our community. There are many people to thank as we bring this project to fruition. First of all, for the vision and foresight of our former county commissioners, Peter Davis, Bucko Shields, and Vivian Wright, who were among the members of the Board of Commissioners when this building was purchased in the 1970s. I saw Mr. Davis the other day and told him about this ribbon cutting today and invited him to attend. Those folks are still working hard in our community. And it was just a little bit of trivia. Commissioner Vivian Wright worked for the Tidewater Power Company for many years before she went on to become the first woman to serve as the new Hanover County Board of Commissioners. So she had great foresight. For the decision that they made to protect this great asset, I would like to thank former commissioners Jason Thompson, Representative Rick Catlin, and Representative Ted Davis for your stewardship and decision to move forward in this renovation. We would like to thank the City of Wilmington, our architects and contractors, for their partnerships in this team effort. And we'll be hearing more about the preservation efforts and modern efficiencies added in just a moment. As always, we all want to thank our great New Hanover County staff for their dedication and commitment to service to our citizens and the delivery of service to our citizens each and every day. Thank you all for being with us. And now I would like to invite any of my fellow commissioners to step forward to also offer remarks. Thank you.
You know, for me, this is a pretty cool day to be out here. This building I have a lot of history with. As you all know, my father served as the county commissioner here for 12 years. And as a young boy, I would come here as he would have his meetings in this particular building right here, as well as the county offices. It was until a little later when they actually renovated the historic courthouse and moved their meetings there. So I just think it's a great day for the community as a whole to see this building open up. You know, as a sitting county commissioner then, it was a no-brainer to invest up to $10 million in this facility here to bring it back to life, to make it more modern for our employees here, the folks that work in the public defender's office, the garden and Litem program, to make sure they had an office space that was fit for the service that they provide, number one, but gave them a great sense of pride in being where they are. It was a no-brainer to indeed make this building what it is today and to recognize its historic significance. I'm glad that our Registrar of Deeds will be here. I think it's going to provide a greater level of service for our citizens here. Those that are in wheelchairs won't have to worry about trying to maneuver around a building and go up a ramp. They can roll right in here and get the services that they need. And again, for the taxpayers in our community, we thank you for your investment, your belief in us to serve our community, but your investment in this building is going to serve for many, many years to come. May God bless this site.
I love being proved wrong. I absolutely do. Those of you who have been around know that in 2011 and 2012, when this building was being discussed, I spoke out very strongly about my concerns of whether or not it could be repaired, whether it could be saved. The mold, the massive water invasion and intrusion between the exterior walls, the interior walls, the non-functioning elevators, the HVAC system that was totally trashed, the masonry cracks that extended from the foundation all the way up to the penthouse at the top there. How in the world could we save it? How could we fix the claustrophobic hallways, the lack of sunlight on the interior, the rooms inside that had the low ceilings caused by slab placements that were out of date? How could that be solved? All I can say is that we're standing before what I would now say is a minor miracle. And I can only thank the brilliance and the creativity of John Sawyer, the architect, the hard work of John Monteith and Monteith Construction, and of course, our own county employees, Kevin Caison, as a project supervisor, and Jerome, thank you so much for making this possible. And I stand here saying thank you to the county commissioners who had the vision to help prove me wrong 4 years later. Thank you very much.
Thank you. At this point, I'd like to bring John Sawyer, the president of Sawyer, Sherwood & Associate Architecture, a new name, I gather, and John Brashears from Monteith Construction. They were the miracle workers.
Rob, you have a way of really, you know, turning up the heat. Neither one of us Johns are as good as you all are at public speaking, so we're going to read our statements.
He is brilliant, though.
No, I'm not brilliant. Chairman Dawson, county commissioners, and the leaders of our community, I want to thank you for supporting this successful building project. The building is again providing excellent workspace. The building itself is one of the few mid-century modern buildings in the city, and when it was built in 1951, it was progressive and included many attributes that we to this day value, such as abundant daylight for the interior and windows that open. Early in our work, as we opened the elevator doors to measure the elevator pit, that's a delightful task, by the way. Derek Wittenberg with New Hanover County's Property Management Office said, if you need any original drawings, I think I know where they are. We closed the elevator doors and followed Derek. The drawings, the original drawings saved by the Property Management Office were indispensable and helped us uncover historically significant details like the neon lighting along 4th Street. That's not something we dreamed up. It was there. It was covered up. And the stand-up lettering on the 4th Street canopy, that also was original to the building. It says 320 Chestnut now, but the original drawings detailed all of that. As I said, the neon was intact. It was partially intact. It was just covered up. The original design of the 4th Street and the Chestnut Street elevations has been restored based on the original drawings. All of us remember this building as being sort of having silvery windows, having a lot of things that you don't see now. And what we found was that a lot of the renovations that had been done in the 60s and 70s were not true to the original design. So we restored those elevations. And the other thing about this building is that in the early 50s, the architects that designed this building assumed that Wilmington was in a boom time, that this building would have a neighboring building about where we're all sitting, and that it would be of similar size. So this elevation of the building really was never intended to become prominent. As we all know, it did, because the building that was to be beside it never occurred. One of the things we did in our design was we corrected that. We added the stair way, which improves safety in this building dramatically. It encloses an exit. We added the glass wall behind us, the glass-walled hallway, which you'll see. That helped the office space tremendously, because before, the exit went through the office spaces. And we added this entrance, which orients the building more towards this parking lot. So I like to think of it as this open space is the table. All these buildings, and now finally this building, have a place at the table. Some of the much of the building is now new. It has new energy efficient and historically accurate windows. They still open. The windows on the 4th and Chestnut Street side look like the old windows, but they do. They have insulating glass, and they are high performance. The progressive energy efficient design of sunshades, which, you know, we refined it with our sunshades, but it's not a new idea. It was here in the 50s, and architects are coming back to that. as being a very energy efficient conservation measure. The building interior is mostly new, designed to better serve the offices located here. And some of the office holders were a bit reluctant about returning to this building. We solved the problem. We took them up on the roof. We showed them the roof. We showed them the view from the roof. And we explained our vision of the roof becoming a great break area and retreat. And without a doubt, every one of them said, "I'm in. I want to be here." So it's a great project for our firm. I want to also thank my partners, Doug Sherwood, Scott Spike. Without them, this wouldn't have happened, I can guarantee you. Doug Jones, a structural engineer on the project, did amazing things for us. David Sims and his group did all of the plumbing, mechanical, and electrical work. We couldn't have done it without a great contractor, Monteith Construction, and we certainly could not have done it without the county having the wisdom to assign Kevin Caison to this project. Without his leadership, you can think of this as a major renovation of a historic house. You find all kinds of things, and with Kevin's support, it really takes a team effort. Kevin gave it to us. We got decisions when we needed it, and we're very thankful. Thank you.
As a company and members of the community, we take great pride in the renovation of this 1950s building into a modern space while preserving its historical integrity. With any older building, the demolition phase is also an exploratory phase. We started to tear out everything working from the top down, and because the ceilings were plastered, the design team didn't have full access to the existing structural framing. So as we were tearing out the old walls and ceilings, we were laying out the new interior stair, the hallway, and exterior additions, and verifying the existing structural framing that had to be modified to be able to hold the green roof system. By taking this approach, we eliminated a fair amount of potential issues before the first piece of steel was ever delivered to the job site. During the footing excavation, we encountered human remains that had been sealed 10 feet beneath the existing concrete slab for 100 years or better. Through close communication between Kevin Caison, the Sheriff's Department, and the archaeology team at UNCW, we were able to continue work in other areas of the building while respectfully preserving the remains. The good folks at UNCW grew so accustomed to wearing the full safety apparel, they eventually blended in with the construction crews. Through daily meetings and on-site layout, we installed a modern MEP system in an overhead space that was never built to house the type of plumbing, mechanical, and electrical systems we use today. And as with all renovations, there were unforeseen and challenges that through close on-site coordination between the owner, design team, and contractors, we were able to overcome in a timely fashion. That's all I've got.
Looks like a serious safety issue. Sorry about that. At this point, I'd like to bring forward Jared Taylor, who's with New Hanover County Property Management, to talk a little bit about the energy systems in the building.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Jared with Property Management, and I'm the Energy Program Specialist here for New Hanover County. As you have heard, we're no doubt very excited about the opening and operation of this building and the features that go into it. You've heard about the green roof and how it can save up to 25% on the heating and cooling costs here in this building and extend the roofing membrane lifespan by about 200%. The high efficiency HVAC system that we're expecting to perform about 25% better than a conventional system. The lighting controls that go into this building to save money on wasted electricity. To the building design itself that you've heard mentioned already with the windows, the layout, how it will allow daylight to get in to those interior offices. We know the effects that this has on employees, and we no doubt are looking forward to those who will be able to occupy this building. Down to the non-VOC paint that was put in, all of these small details that contributed to the sustainability of this building. And it really represents a commitment to sustainability here at New Hanover County. You know, it really isn't only this building. It extends out to all of our properties. We've incorporated these principles into our standard operations, from the replacement of how we go about removing and replacing our HVAC systems, to the purchase of energy efficient LED lighting that goes in standard into our buildings now. Also within New Hanover County, there are employees who on their own have formed the sustainability committee, and they're all committed to sustainability and energy efficiency here in New Hanover County and making a difference. As the nation continues to progress as a whole towards energy efficient design and operation in publicly owned facilities, you know, we here at New Hanover County, we remain committed to keeping in step and also innovative in our approach to the buildings. So basically, for me to sum up, this building represents New Hanover County's emphasis on sustainable design, building operation, and the efficient use of our facilities. Thank you.
Thank you, Jared. At this point, Chris Coudray, our county manager, will be speaking.
Good afternoon. What a way to start the new year. January 4th, we start with a new building, a board meeting tonight, just a great day to be an employee of New Hanover County, but I think just as importantly, if not more importantly, to be a resident and a citizen and a taxpayer of this community. What a testament to long-term vision. This building, if I'm right, on January 1st, started its 64th year of life, and I have no reason to believe that in another 64 years, when most of us have long gone from at least the jobs that we're doing, there won't still be county employees, state employees, and other public service leaders doing business in this building for what will then be probably 400,000 residents of this wonderful county. I actually have a special recognition that I'd like to make today, but I think I should begin first with thanking the board that was in place in September of 2012, who voted in favor of this renovation by showing confidence in its staff, who brought forward the recommendation, but also the design team led by John Sawyer. Thank you for having the confidence in us, all of us, the design team and the staff, to let this day happen. And certainly thank you to the Board of Commissioners that we have today, that who has kept us pushing and moving in the right direction, who was expecting us to deliver a project, as the chair said, not only on time, but within budget. And we did that. We certainly met the within budget, and I hope those of you in the media that are here will report that. We are within budget, and also within 30 days of the original delivery date that was slowed a bit by the discovery of human remains that date from the late 1790s, and also the identification of a bit of asbestos that was not known when we did the original asbestos survey. So thank you to the board of 2012, thank you to the board of 2014, and thank you to the board of 2016. We have thanked a number of individuals today, and I'm so happy that everybody who spoke knew the importance of Kevin Caison in this project. We at New Hanover County are lucky to have someone with the talent and the capability and the experience that Kevin Caison brings to us. And I'm so happy that he is serving as our project manager and that he has been involved not only in this project, but recently changes at the Cape Fear Museum. We're about to see changes just across the street at the New Hanover County Public Library, working on renovations to the health department. The list continues, and all of these projects have been delivered within budget, and I'm happy for you to report that again, and all of them generally within the expected time frame. Kevin, I see you far in the corner. I'd like to ask you to come forward, if you would, and I will ultimately put pressure on you to say something, if you're willing to do it. New Hanover County has, I think, a very special, important, and meaningful way of recognizing the folks, the 1,700 men and women who do the work of the county on your behalf, and that's why we're here. We're here to implement the policies of the board, but to work on your behalf and execute and deliver the things that you want and expect of your county government. I think we're pretty good at recognizing employees. We have a program or an initiative that is called Rise, Reach for the Stars. And I think Kevin has embodied the idea of what reaching for the stars means. And as an executive leadership team, we made the decision we wanted to nominate him for our most important award, and that's the Stellar Award that probably 50 county employees over the course of a couple of years have received. And it's only appropriate that Kevin be identified and added to that list. And it's a bit long, but I hope you will indulge me. I hope it's okay to the board for me to read what we put together to ensure Kevin was recognized and chosen by a group of his peers. The folks who select the winners of these awards are not the executive leadership team. They're co-workers amongst 1,700 staff. And Kevin, your peers, your colleagues recognize the value of your work throughout the organization, and in particular with bringing 320 back to life. So if I may read just a bit about Kevin and what led to his selection by his peers for a Stellar Award. Kevin Caison fosters a productive work environment by exhibiting the drive and the impetus to make things happen. And isn't that what we want in every public employee? To be successful on this project, Kevin demonstrated his ability to balance technical and management skills and to juggle different views and perspectives, different backgrounds, and certainly different personalities. He maintained focus, ensuring the team's performance was optimized and the project's objectives were met. Kevin also embraced the mission to incorporate the principles of sustainability into the project, ensuring an energy-efficient building and an outstanding workplace for everyone who uses and occupies this building. Many projects are compared to going on a journey, with the excitement, the twists, and the turns that can take place traveling toward a destination. This project was no exception. State-of-the-art technical and innovative features were incorporated into the renovation of this building. The green roof, and to my knowledge, it still is the only publicly owned green roof in southeastern North Carolina. The green roof, lighting, the HVAC, and automated door system are just a few examples of these innovations. It took countless hours and meetings to achieve what has been accomplished in this building. Additionally, the historic nature of the building was respected at every stage of the renovation. Whether it was discovering the human remains, as I said, that date from at least the late 1700s, preserving the original marble flooring in the building, or maintaining the design integrity of a mid-century modern American form of design. Mid-century, 20th century, and we will be here in mid-century, 21st century. Integrity and design of the building exterior, and Kevin made provisions to adapt to ensure everything was done according to plan. It is through Kevin's dedication, determination, and untiring efforts that we have a real treasure at 320 Chestnut Street. He delivered an outstanding project, and he did it on time and within budget. For all those reasons and more, we were all pleased to nominate Kevin Caison, one of our outstanding New Hanover County employees, to receive the Stellar Award. No surprise that Kevin was awarded this by his peers and his colleagues. And so, Kevin, I'd like to formally present to you today, January the 4th, 2016, Reach for the Stars. For the service above and beyond the call of duty, New Hanover County is proud to award Kevin Caison the Stellar Award for the shared values of stewardship and accountability. You have reached for the stars in your actions to serve the citizens of New Hanover County and your fellow public servants. Congratulations, and thank you for doing what you do. Thank you for being a part of this organization.
Can I coach you in the same thing?
Yeah.
Sure. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. I didn't know this was going to happen, so I'm not prepared at all. But even if I was prepared, I don't know what to say other than I really don't deserve all this praise. It was so easy working with everybody that was involved. Seriously, it was. Made my job extremely easy. Everybody from the architect and contractor that was involved to the occupants being very patient with the design changes that came along, and I really just feel like I was just doing my job, and I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Kevin. I knew if we prepared him, he would have said no, so this is good. At this point, we're here for the main event. We're here for a ribbon cutting. I'd like to ask Jerome Fennell, who leads our property management department, and Kevin to please hold the ribbon.
Welcome to 320 Chestnut.
Woo!
320 Chestnut.